This is Unit 4B. It deals with static electricity and specifically the uses of static electricity. So working left to right, we've got the electrostatic precipitator here. Now what's going on here, this is in a chimney. We've got smoke particles coming up here from the furnace, and as you can see there's a grid here and they pick up a charge, a negative charge, so the electrons you can see are now on the soot particles. Obviously this isn't the scale. Now as it flies up, they're attracted to the positive plates here inside the chimney, and we get a build-up of soot. Eventually, when that's a really thick layer, a hammer will come along, it'll all fall down, and it's removed. So the purpose of this is to stop soot particles going to the atmosphere. Moving along then, we've got painting here. Now, normally conventional painting can get very splodgy, messy, and if it misses, it misses. Now, charged powder painting is very different. Here we have the gun, and it gives the powder a charge, and that's the opposite charge to whatever's being painted, a bike frame in this case. The first thing it does is it gives you, as it says here, nice fine spray, because all the little bits of powder are repelling each other constantly, want to get away from each other. So they're attracted to the object, much less ends up on the ground, and also it ends up in very awkward places, even behind or out of sight of the gun. So they'll fly around, and even if they overshoot, they'll be attracted back. So it's a very handy, money-saving device. Finally, we've got the defibrillator. Now, this relates to medicine. Fibrillation is when the heart beats in an irregular way or stops beating altogether. Now, I'm sure you've seen this on medical dramas. Two pads added, it's charged up, so you have a load of electrons ready to go. It's put on the body, button is pressed, charge flows through from this pad, through the heart, to the other pad, and hopefully it will restart the heart successfully. So there we are, 4B, uses of static.